Well, it has to do with the number one thing on my list.
Tell me.
Well, when me and Terrence were living in Alabama, and I was just a baby, Daddy and Mommy were working Martin Luther King to change the laws to have black people segregated. There were lots of white people who didn't like this, and one night, some of them went on to a lawn. They were part of the Ku Klux Klan.
What happened?
Terrence told me all about this. Usually he won't talk about none, but this one time I asked, how come he's so angry at white people all the time? So he told me. He said it was an extra hot night, just like this one, and Mom was rocking me to sleep. Daddy was helping Karen with his raving, and they heard a sound in the animals in the yard. So they went to see what it was. Daddy and Terrence were laughing about stuff, but when they opened the door, there was a ring of men all around their yard. They had on white sheets and pointy hats, with only the eye holes cut out. And they lit a cross of fire right outside of the door. Terrence said that it smelled like ash, and he couldn't breathe, staring at all those things. One of them started calling Daddy bad names. He yelled, come on out and we'll let your family go. And Terrence said right then on Daddy's face crumbled up like a paper burning in a flame. That's exactly how he described it.
What happened? Did he go out?
Terrence said that's when Mama came flying down the stairs. She had these flashed her chest and she slammed that door shut and held on to Daddy real tight. Then she grabbed Terrence's arm so hard it hurt and dragged him into the bedroom. She made him climb into the clothes hamper even though he could barely fit in. Then she handed me a promise, she said to Terrence, that you won't come out until your daddy or I says you do. Promise that you'll be just and quiet. Promise, Mom said. She said it over and over again until he had promised so many. He had promised many. Then she and Daddy were gone so long, Terrence thought they were dead. And the whole time, he sat in the clothes and prayed. And he whispered into my ear like he was telling me a story, so it never made sense.
Then what happened?
They stayed a long time. Then around 1 o'clock in the morning, cops burned out and they left their yard. The next day, Daddy got all the pastors from different churches together, white and black. They went up to visit each of the people who had been dressed up in the white sheets.
What did he do that for? How did he know who they were if they were wearing sheets? What happened once they saw him?
Daddy says everyone knows who's in the Ku Klux Klan. He says even though they keep themselves hidden, a man can keep his views hidden in real life, and it's not hard to figure out who they are.
Wasn't he afraid?
Yes, but Daddy said he wanted everyone to know that he knew who they were. He said that people will do things they wouldn't do otherwise if they think no one could see them. After that, he figured that the Ku Klux Klan would either kill him or let him be.
We got the Ku Klux Klan around here, don't we?
I know for sure we do.
How do you know?
Mr. Edwards told me.
He did?
Do you want to know what he said? He said that if me and you aren't careful, the Klan might play up soon as it's done that.
Gabe stood up so quick his feet barely made it.
I'm telling Pop.
Don't! Your papa told my daddy and I'll get in trouble with something fierce. Daddy told me that I wasn't to go around people like Mr. Evans, and if he finds out, he'll be so mad.
But what if they are coming? But what if they are dressed up right now?
They wouldn't.
You hear something?
No, do you?
No.
At that moment, they did hear something. It sounded like a twig snapping outside the tent. They sat real still.
What was that?
I don't know. Think Mom and Pop will hear us.
three. One, two.
They screamed louder than they had ever screamed before. They both stood up at once and started to run. Only the kids got to the tent. Since Gabe promised they wouldn't let go of Frida's hand, they both only had one thing to work with. And they sure did think that as somebody said, the whole tent fell down on top of them. Only it felt like maybe someone pushed it down. Then, two huge arms are pulled down the floor. Thank you.